It's time for the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach, Jimmy Carter. Joining Coach Carter is Pirate host, Derek Draper.
Welcome to the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach, Jimmy Carter. I'm Derek Draper, and Coach Carter, Pirates won 5 straight games going to the Crosstown Showdown last week. I know there was a last-minute change of plans on Wednesday of last week. You made changes to really good move to from Friday to Thursday. Mm-hmm. And how'd that change come about?
You know, just monitoring the weather all week. You know, Coach Gold and I had been in communication, and Wednesday morning early, you know, we talked and you know, looking at the forecast and looking with our athletic trainers, you know, and getting a detailed forecast, you know, it just looked like the best possible scenario, you know, would be to play the game Thursday night, you know. And it was, you know, good weather Thursday night. And, you know, in hindsight, it was a good move because Friday night we wouldn't have probably kicked off till about 8:45.
So I was say, looking at the weather and everything Friday night, in hindsight, it probably been over about midnight or
oh,
so.
Oh, yeah.
And so, yeah. And, you know, in hindsight, I think it's a good move. I know it was stressful to get everything with moving the JV freshman games to Wednesday night. So I know there was a lot of pressure there on Wednesday to get everything done. Well, I know the Pirates came on the short end of the stick on the Crosstown Showdown. It was 17-6 at half. Pirates had a good drive in the second quarter, going 72 yards and 7 plays. And Samuel Aquay had a ESPN type of catch there in the end zone. Yeah. I don't know how he caught that ball. It looked like I couldn't tell where the ball landed.
Yeah.
And then they signaled touchdown.
Yeah, that was a great catch. I mean, you can see it on the end zone copy of our film, and it's an amazing catch that he made.
What'd you tell your players at halftime?
We knew it was going to be a dog fight, you know, and we were in a fight, and, you know, and we'd taken a couple licks in the mouth, and we threw one, and, you know, we just had to come back out in the second half and get after it.
I think it was Pirates offensively. It was tough night after watching the film. What were some good things that the offense did on Thursday?
I thought that our intensity was there. I thought our effort was there all night long. We just couldn't quite catch a break. You know, we had 11 drops. Mm-hmm. That's what our offensive staff charted, 11 just drops, not bad thrown balls or anything like that. Mm-hmm. We picked a bad night to drop some
balls,
you know.
Yeah.
I mean, we dropped 2 down here, inside the red zone mm-hmm. to get points, And so, anytime you squander an opportunity like that, it's hard to overcome it, But I thought our kids fought the whole 4 quarters.
Defensively, the Pirates held the Raiders to 2 field goals in the second half. Really, what adjustments did the defense make at halftime?
I thought not a lot of schematic adjustments. Mm-hmm. Just kept playing hard. And we knew that. That Fisher and Henderson were going to be hard to tackle, and they broke some tackles on us, and we had a short field one time, and mm-hmm. But I was very proud of our defense. They stepped up and playing hard and getting better each and every week.
Yeah, East averages 48 points per game and 460 total yards. Pirates held them to 23 points and 292 total yards. And going back, who were some standouts offensively?
I thought as it has been all year long, Harrison Bicek's done a great job, at the linebacker spot. I think Jaden Droge and Brady Light did mm-hmm. a phenomenal job up front. They just relentless effort and attitude, that they have, fighting up front all night long.
And as far as the opposite side of the ball, who some standouts offensively?
Daylon Gordon again, mm-hmm. Had over 100 yards rushing. Your offensive line, did mm-hmm. we did a good job. We protected Jagger. He was rushed a few times, but, for mm-hmm. all in all, they did a great job.
Well, what did you tell your team after the game?
I told them I was proud of them for the effort. The biggest thing is, I would have liked to have seen if we had only had 5 drops, and I know we don't go out and we don't do it on purpose and things like that. It wasn't purposeful mistakes, but they were at crucial times in the ball game, but we picked a bad night to have a bad night, And so, proud of the effort, proud of the fight that they put up and half the teams in the state of Texas put their stuff up, Thursday or Friday night, and we're living on.
Well, thanks for joining us for the first half of the Dickey's Barbecue Show. Stay tuned for the second half.
Since 1941, Dickey's Barbecue Pit has been smoking the very best quality meats for 14 hours every day. It's how Mr. Dickey did it, and it's how we still do it in every Dickey's restaurant across America. Come in and see us or visit Dickey's.com.
Welcome back to the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show with Wiley Pirate head football coach Jimmy Carter. Coach Carter, this coming Friday night, hopefully it's going to be Friday.
Yes,
I don't think there's any weather coming in.
The weather looks good this week. Yeah.
But this coming Friday night, the Pirates travel, first round of playoffs. It's what you refer to as the third season. They go to North Forney on November the 15th at 7 o'clock. Is that what time game time is? North Forney. Head coach is Marcus Shavers, who was in McKinney for several years. The Pirates played him, I believe, in 2018 in the playoffs.
Yep.
And they're North Forney. They're 7-3 on the season, 5-1 in district play. What kind of offense do they run, and who are some of their offensive personnel? I know you had Howard Fisher. You had that combo last week. You've got another tough combo this week.
Yeah, I got another tough combo. You know, they're led by their quarterback, Legend Bay, who leads the Metroplex in rushing, you know, this year, and didn't play the first two ball games of the year, you know, so he's doing that on eight games. They're going to – it's kind of a smash-mouth football. They're going to get in there foot-to-foot in the offensive line. They're big and strong, and, you know, they're going to hand it off to a big, strong, physical running back, and then, you know, the quarterback's going to run it too. So they're you know, they want to run the football. They want to pound the football. They want to punish you. They're a big physical offensive football team.
And who are some of their key personnel besides their quarterback that's going to impact
them? Yeah, you know, the running back, his name slips my mind right now, but, you know, he's big and physical also, also, and, you know, fast. He'll hit that hole, you know. Their offensive line is big and strong, you know. Just when I say foot to foot, now it's going to look like their offensive line is about from tackle to tackle, about that wide, you know. They're in there nice and tight. But, you know, just athletic at the receiver spot, too. They're probably 70-30 run to pass.
Well, defensively, what kind of scheme do they run? And then who are some of their key personnel playmakers?
Yeah, you know, defensively, they're going to give you a couple different looks. They're going to give you a three-man front look and kind of reduce down and give you a four-man every now and then. You know, they like to hit. You know, they're fast. They're physical. D-line's big and strong. I told the kids, you know, this morning, it's going to be another game like it was against Wiley East. Very similar type, you know, maybe a little different offensively, but the same type of offense. And defensively, the same thing. You know, they're fast and they're going to hit you. And, you know, but I like our chances. You know, if we play with the effort that we did last week against Wiley East and eliminate some of those mistakes, then we'll be in the ballgame, you know, late in the fourth quarter.
No, they got a couple of D1 cornerbacks out there in the secondary, and are they pretty quick?
You know, they're quick, fast, and you know, they're physical. And so, but you know, like I said, you know, I like the matchup. I like what we do, and I think we can do some things to give them some problems.
What kind of game do you anticipate on Friday?
It's going to be a very physical football game on both sides. You know, I think our defense is very physical. I think their defense is physical. You know, we've shown flashes on offense that we can be really physical. And so, you know, their offense is physical. So it's going to be a smash-mouth football game. You know, and like I said, you know, if we can eliminate some mistakes, you know, we can give ourselves a chance in the fourth quarter.
The Pirates play first round of playoffs, third season, as Coach Carter refers to it. North Forney Falcons, they're at North Forney Friday, November 15th. Once you're there, 7 p.m., how do Pirate fans get tickets for this game?
I don't believe the tickets are up and running yet, but it'll be on the North Forney website. You can go there. It's hometown ticketing, just like you'd buy tickets here.
And as far as on video or streaming, I don't know if NFHS.
I would assume during the playoffs, NFHS, you know, kind of picks that up. You kind of have to pay for that, you know, subscription. But, you know, you'll be there carrying the broadcast.
Yeah, we got the broadcast free. WileyPirateFootball.com. We'll have Coach Carter's pregame interview. We'll also have a preview of the men's soccer season with Coach Dillon at halftime. And then we'll also have the Dickey's Barbecue Trivia contest. So Coach, anything else before we wrap this thing up?
I just like to congratulate our girls volleyball program, you know, just making it to the third round. And you know, they play Tuesday night down in Leon, so against the defending state champion Grand Oaks. So proud of them.
Game. Yeah, yeah, be a good game. So, well, this wraps it up for the Dickey's Barbecue Coaches Show. For Wiley Pirate Head Football Coach Jimmy Carter, I'm Derek Draper. Thank you for watching.
Almost.